a chance to tell the truth about the greatest love story ever told.
It all started about 5 years ago. I was sitting alone at a girl bar, and then I saw her. She was wearing this tight red dress that highlighted every curve of her body, her breasts, her hip. And then she sat down next to me. Hi. We could both feel it, that instant attraction.
Can I buy you a drink?
34 days sober.
Gotcha. I'm just getting out of the drug world myself.
And then we left. We wanted time to be alone.
So how long are you in town?
The weekends. I'm trying to close this deal, but my heart's not in it.
She was trying to close a deal, all right. She was dating a man so she could use his hotel for her illegal plastic surgery ring. And her heart wasn't in it because, well, Rose was a lesbian.
I really did not expect this.
You never know when lightning's gonna strike. And then she kissed me. I thought I'd never see her again. And then I went to a family dinner that night. It was a horrible night. My dad was all over my brother. Oh my god.
Oh good, you made it!
I am so sorry I'm late. Traffic was terrible.
You're dating my father?
Please lower your voice. Yeah. What about last night? It was a mistake. I really do have feelings for you. It is getting serious. Look, I think I needed to be with a woman one last time, you know? Just get it out of my system. Yeah. I mean, I have a girlfriend anyway. Her name's Allison. She loves to ask me some flowers. Good. Mashed potatoes, I'm sure.
I didn't know who was to call.
You said it was an emergency?
I artificially inseminated the wrong woman, so I need a lawyer.
I don't practice law anymore, you know that.
I'm scared. I need someone that I can talk to.
Your wife. Your brother.
I walked in on Allison last night in bed with her assistant.
I'm sorry that happened. Louisa, you're not drinking, are you?
No. No, I'm not. What I'm doing is that I'm trying to be practical, which is why I called you. I mean, you were a pretty good lawyer before you gave it up to become a trophy wife.
You're crazy, you know that?
Don't call me crazy.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean... We can't. What are you doing?
Leave him.
What?
Let's go somewhere. Together. You don't love him.
What happened yesterday was a mistake. It's not gonna happen again.
Oh my god, I did not expect you to call.
I can't stay away from you. I try. Is that the psychedelic drink that makes you constantly vomit?
Exactly, but it's like you're vomiting out everything that's wrong with your life. It's really difficult to describe, but I had a shaman and I was guided through this journey, and in my journey, I saw everything so clearly.
We should talk.
I would really like that.
I was just so worried about you.
how I felt about you. It's part of what I was running from. No, I get that. I came here to be truthful and honest. And if I'm being truthful and honest, I still want to be with you. I want us to tell everyone what happened and just run away together. We can't do that. It's over. For real this time.
What? What's going on?
I'm so sorry, Louisa. I had to tell them what you were saying.
Tell them what?
About us.
You mean our affair.
See? Louisa, you're having some sort of episode. Fantasizing about me.
What? What?
Louisa, you gotta stay calm.
We were lovers!
Louisa, hi.
What are you doing here?
I need to see you. I feel so terribly about what happened. Look, you were threatening to tell about our affair, and I panicked. I just panicked, and I feel so ashamed. I mean, I'm an adult, and it's 2015, and I'm not ready to admit that I want to be with a woman. And I want to be with you. I just have such a nice life with your father.
Good. Go back to it.
Louisa, please. I haven't been able to sleep.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm in a mental institution.
Do you realize what your father would put us through if he found out?
You could have broken up with me. You didn't have to come at me. Louisa, please.
Get out of here.
Get out.
Louisa, please, just let me say one thing to you. I'm sorry. And I love you. And here.
You think this makes up for you locking me up?
No. I can't make that up to you. But I can do other things. And I hope I'm not sounding too desperate. I need love and affection. La 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 la. Love and affection. La 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 la. Look, I don't know what made you change your mind and decide to sign me out, but I cannot believe it.
Rose is Sinrostro.
Come again?
Rose, our stepmother? Is Sin Rostro.
Sin Rostro, like that crazy big drug dealer person?
Yeah, except she got out of drugs and now runs a plastic surgery ring and apparently changes criminals' faces.
You don't think? Sin Rostro, like, killed people, right?
Only those who really deserved it.
Lou, I am so sorry.
Great. Louisa, there's so much I want to say to you, but can't. So let me say this. I'm sorry that you were hurt during all of this.
I love you. And I know I shouldn't. I tried to stop. But I can't let go. Because there's a part of me that thinks that she's coming back for me. That we're going to be together. I don't need her in my life.
Louisa.
Mm-hmm. I can't.
Look, I know you were helping us when you were talking about how you felt about Rose. That sounded real.
It's because I never got closure.
No, but for us, now's not the time.
Love and affection.
You wouldn't give me a second chance.
Not if you knew it was me. Because you killed my father.
Yes, and I regret that. But I love you, Louisa. I've always loved you. Why are you talking in that creepy voice?
It wasn't supposed to be creepy, it was supposed to be sexy. See, I don't even know how to talk to you anymore. You make me so nervous.
No, I make you nervous?
Yes! You're the only person that I have ever felt this way about.
You fell in love with me twice. Let's build a life together. Please. If I have sex with you once, it doesn't mean that I'm saying yes.
You go back to Miami, tell the cops everything. When I'm around your family, I'll have a different face.
That's the thing. You, around my family.
I've changed. I'm done with crime. You have to trust that. And if you can't, if you're going to jump whenever I enter a room, then I'll drop you off at Port Kembla. You can fly home and never hear from me again. So? What's it going to be?